I bet you spend a lot of time reading for homework. I do, and I used to wonder why, after spending so much time reading, I was still not prepared for my exams. Finally, a friend taught me how to read college-level textbooks and readings. It has completely changed how I do all my reading. I'm learning much more and doing better on my tests without having to cram at the last minute. First, the basics. Make sure you are reading in an active position and decide which tools work best for you. Paper to take notes, sticky notes, highlighters, colored pencils, whatever tools work for you. This is not leisurely reading, this is serious work. The technique that works best for me is the P2R method. It stands for preview, read actively, and review. First, the big preview. At the beginning of the course, skim through each textbook you have been assigned. Skim from the title page all the way to the end, including reference pages. As you do this, ask yourself, what is in this textbook to help me learn? Preview the book to find out. Look for things in the textbook, such as quizzes and answers, charts, summaries, a glossary, and other additional material. Start each reading session with a mini preview of just that reading assignment. Skim the chapter you are going to read while answering the question to yourself, what am I going to learn from this text? Be sure to pay attention to titles, headings, section introductions, vocabulary words, and the summary at the end. Pay attention to any visual in your text. Often the visuals are a quick summary or illustration of what you have just read. Pay attention to any and all questions asked in the chapter and vocabulary that you need to know. At the end of this skim, come up with 2 to 4 questions you want to answer while you read your chapter. You might have a study guide from your professor, or you might need to anticipate what she wants you to learn from this particular reading assignment. Reading with questions in mind really helps your mind to focus. Now you are ready to actively read. Your brain should be working hard. Use a pointer, a pen, or even your finger to guide your reading. This sounds silly, but it will keep your eyes focused and your reading on track. As you read, take notes at the end of each section of this chapter. These notes become your study guide with questions and answers. You could create visual notes, such as a mind map or a brief 1 or 2 sentence summary by each paragraph or section. These notes can be as colorful as you would like, but should contain only key words, no more than a sentence or two at the most. You can write these on your text, on a sticky note, or even a separate piece of paper or a note card. Be sure to include the page number on each paper. This will be important when you study from these later in the semester. Be sure that your notes contain the answers to the questions you asked at the beginning of the chapter. Now that you have completed all the studying from your textbook, you might think it is all over. Not so. Now is the exciting part. Can you recall what you have just read? Will you recall all this information for a test or exam in a week, month, or 3 months from now? To test yourself, engage in at least 1 active review strategy. These are the very best ways to help your brain actually learn everything you just read and took notes on. Test yourself. See if you can answer the questions from memory you created before you read your chapter. Write down the answer. Type it out. Say it out loud. If you can do this, then celebrate. If not, go back to your study mind maps or trigger words. Go through the mind maps, sticky notes, or note cards you created and teach the principles to someone else. If there's no study group or study partner available, then teach your teddy bear, mirror, or a willing roommate, friend, or family member. If you find you cannot answer the questions or explain the information to yourself or someone else, then go back to your mind maps or notes, or even the text and reread the information. It is better to find gaps in your knowledge now, when you still have time to fill those gaps, rather than in the exam, where you would have to leave the questions blank. As you continue to read your textbook throughout the semester, keep going back to actively review previous chapters. Remember, for your review to be effective, it needs to be active. Don't just glance at your notes. Test yourself. Reading this way takes a lot more focus and effort, but you actually learn the material. It takes effort the same way working out takes effort, but you will get great results. You won't waste any more time reading without actually learning.